And now, the stunning conclusion of Life is Strange 2. I'm Amethyst Luna, beginning the final chapter, chapter 5. Wolves. Who said dust to dust? Is this subchapter names? Very interesting. Anyway, wolves! Oh! I'm not convinced these people are gone from the end of last episode. They're both still alive. Once
upon a time, in a wild, wild world.
And the gun's still there.
There were two wolf brothers living in their home lair with their papa wolf. They lived in peace until hunters took their dad away. The wolf brothers wandered for days and nights, learning how to live on their own. For the first time. That's when the big brother discovered that the little one was not an ordinary wolf, but a super wolf. They decided to head south to the distant land of their ancestors. But the journey was long and dangerous. Still, the wolf brothers made new friends on the way. They learned more about the world. But danger seemed to always follow them after a bad accident. They were separated. The big brother had been hurt, and the hunters finally captured him. They put him in a cage. But when he finally escaped, he went to search for his little brother. He soon found out that the little wolf had joined a coyote cult, and he would not leave them.
A coyote cult.
Suddenly, their mother showed up after all that time. She said she came to help rescue him. They begged the coyote leader, but she would not release the little wolf. He was their idol. So they had to knock her out to escape. The wolf brothers, now reunited, followed their rogue mother far into the desert to her hideaway.
Did they actually go to her house? Because we didn't see that. We saw a hotel room. Arizona, I was gonna say New Mexico. 7 weeks after the events at Haven Point. Oh, we got a scorpion. It's funny, I lived in Arizona for 4 years, never saw a single scorpion. I saw one snake. It was dead. So maybe I was lucky. We call it the arid zone.
Sean?
Hey.
Dude, come on.
What?
We gotta book on the constellations.
What time is it?
Daytime.
It's so beautiful. Check it out.
Wow. They're by the Grand Canyon?
So?
Yeah, okay. Good call. Wow. That's amazing.
I know.
sunrise and sunset in Arizona is freaking amazing, I'll tell you that much.
Is your eye okay?
Pink skies.
Yeah. It just itches. It's okay, Nano.
I...
promise.
Yeah. Okay.
He blames himself.
I love you. No matter what happens. You hear me?
Yeah. I love you too. Ow! Ow, ow!
Ow!
Ow, ow, ow!
Ow, ow!
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 They're better at that.
Diaz brothers. Always.
So, are you still having those bad dreams? You know, about Lisbeth?
Yeah. Sometimes, I feel like she's around, coming after me. It's scary.
She might be. She's lucky.
She's lucky you didn't go after her.
Yeah, but she's still out there. Somewhere.
Somewhere, I was about to say that.
Creeps me out.
Well, we're together.
Listen. We're far away from her, okay? We're together again. Safe.
Hope so. Sean. Are we criminals now?
Sort of. Sean definitely is. After the fact.
Sort of. We did a lot of...
shady things.
Illegal shit.
Yeah.
If the cops catch us, we'll be judged for what we did. That's for sure.
Yeah. I know.
But they did what they had to survive.
Well... we're almost at the border. Finally.
I like it here, but we'll have to leave soon. I know.
I'm sorry, Anano.
Sean, I know it's been a long time. Can you tell me the rest of the wolf story?
Yeah, I can tell you.
Oh. Yeah, I can tell you.
Do they hang out with their mother?
Been forever since we left off.
Way too long.
Sounds like they went to her house.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So, thanks to their mama wolf, the wolf brothers barely escaped from the coyote cult. She led them to her secret lair deep in the Red Desert. The wolf brothers rested for a while, but at some point, they'd have to continue their journey south. They were closer than ever to their father's land, but between them and their destination lied.
A mighty fire unicorn. But she's nice.
Okay.
So they become friends.
Who's that?
Excuse me. Who's telling the story?
You are. But it's my story too. Right?
Who's the fire unicorn? Well, yeah, that is true. It is your story, too.
Yeah. That's true. Okay, then. So what happens next?
They arrive in Mexico. But the country is rampaged by goblins. Together, the wolves and the unicorn manage to slay them and become heroes. The police forgives them. And all their friends come to Mexico to celebrate.
Okay.
Yeah. Sounds pretty good, Enano. Let's pack this shit up and head back to town.
Okay. Back to town.
Gotta clean up our stuff before we leave. This place is too pretty.
Their mother's place back in town? Constellations book.
Every star looked the same. Until we used Karen's old guidebook.
Sketchbook. Okay. We didn't see this stuff. Where? Whoa. There's a lot added here. Okay. This we saw. Trucker. We got Daniel. Finally. The freak guru can go to hell now. Feels so good to be with my bro again. Leaving Haven Point, Karen is taking us to her place. We need to sleep. We need to breathe. Sleep. Heal. But Sarah Lee, this needs to go... Oh, bubbles or something? May 15th. Karen lives in a desert commune. Unincorporated community, she said. It's called Away. Only 30 people live here on and off. The place is so weird, but the desert is mind-blowing. The perfect hideaway. Wow. Away. Daniel's still feeling so confused, guilt-tripping a lot. He can't figure out what happened. The brainwashing, the lies, Lisbeth's grasp over his trauma. Doing my best to help him recover. Sure hope they fine now. Karen is a big help, too. She's good with words. That letter from Jacob and Sarah made him happy. Daniel needs more friends. So do I. Sean, we're posing. Lesson 3. Total trip to live with Karen again. June 3rd. She wants to move on. That's easy for her to say. I'm trying. Daniel is getting better. I can see he loves having mommy back. He doesn't remember her in the first place. Daniel's power is no secret here. No one gives a crap. They just go along with it. And don't see it as something they can use to their advantage. Refreshing. Well, should have seen that. Grr. Should have seen that rather than reading about it. Who's gonna tell? We're already the crazy sand people, David. That's the Grr there. So this place Away is what you make it. June 10th. Joan haunts it with cool sculptures made from scavenged scraps. She's a cool and sunny woman. Karen's closest thing to her best friend, it seems. Cool as heck ornamental tattoos. Take my time today. June 15th. Arthur and Stanley live in one of the only proper houses in town. They built it together 10 years ago from ruins of their past lives. These two can't stop teasing each other, but they're so inspiring. Old couple, young love. Mm-hmm. June 17th. Got a letter from Cass today. Feels good. Would love to hang with her again someday. This place makes me want to draw. Could stare at these canyons forever. David needs to vent out. June 30th. He's been having nightmares about Haven Point and Lisbeth for weeks. Still feels guilty about my eye. Need to find ways to help him process this. July 1st. Karen told us about a cool camping spot. Reach the top after a long hike across the canyon. Track sessions feel like forever ago. Need to work on my cardio. Don't fall, mate. Ursa Major. Manhorsarius. Probably the best view ever. Gonna stargaze all night thanks to Arthur's telescope. Daniel seems happy. Cool. Can we draw? Let's draw.
Ooh, sketching time! Good idea.
Haha.
I'm glad you can still draw after. You know.
Me too, Daniel. But if I can see it in my mind, I can still sketch anything. Almost.
That's so cool. I don't want you to stop drawing. Ever.
Okay, then.
Thanks, man.
This is so cool. Hey, can you draw me as a superhero? Like, striking a pose over the canyon.
I can try.
Badass.
My back hurts a little. I'm glad we're sleeping in our bed tonight.
There's a monster in
here. Tada. Finished.
Let me check it out. Jeez. Do I really look that evil?
Huh.
He looks more like a supervillain.
You don't like that, huh? Sleeping bags.
I'm glad we had these. Not a fan of desert critters.
Hey, I can help. Just tell me what you want to put in there.
You are the man.
Backpack. Days are hellfire, but nights can be chilly out here in the desert. We got his pencils. That's lighter. We have to bring water in the desert and you're dead meat. You need more than that. Danny would rather have these things than a cell phone. That canyon. Another picture. He does kind of look like a villain.
So incredible to see all those stars and planets up close. It's like we're right there.
I hope we can go watch the stars again. Mom said there's a moon eclipse coming up soon.
I'm in.
Wow.
This place is cool. I could just move here.
So it is.
Yep. Still need our processed sugar in this hippie desert. God damn. That food was amazing. Thanks, Joanne.
Joanne?
It's so nice and cool in the morning here.
Says Joan.
Then it gets so hot.
Let's clean up this mess.
Not if it cleans up by itself.
Oops, sorry guys.
Stop. Daniel.
Can't catch it, huh?
No shit. Now cut it out.
Jeez. You're no fun.
So it is?
Yep. Still need our processed sugar in this hippie desert.
I really looked at that.
Yo, Captain Cam, can you take these away?
Sure.
And no funny business.
Of course not.
Perfect formation.
Flashlight is the last thing. I can pack the constellation book.
I swear Dad had that same book in the garage.
Yeah, I think he did.
Why did he never show it to us?
Maybe it reminded him of Mom too much.
Oh. Maybe. Yeah. Right.
Pretty useless with the crazy moonlight we had. But it scares the coyotes away.
Yeah, so that's the last thing.
Activate flashlight.
On the way.
Well, let's hit the trail, cowboy.
That's a good way to get the practice in while also packing up.
What are you doing?
Careful with that. Don't do that.
What the fuck, dude? Don't do that.
What's wrong?
Stop messing with it, man.
Yeah, you're right. Sorry, little guy. Don't get eaten by eagles.
Do eagles eat scorpions?
No idea.
Cool.
Probably.
Let's go.
They're kind of small, though. Eagle would like something better to eat.
I wish we saw more falling stars. Or any.
We saw the Milky Way.
Hey, we saw the Milky Way, dude. How cool is that?
Yeah, that's true. And Mars. That was so cool Arthur and Stanley let us use the telescope.
Yeah. These guys are real cool. Hey, see this? Looks like the ones you did back in that cabin. When you got sick.
Oh, totally. Wait, does that mean other people were here?
Of course.
Yeah.
Maybe someone from away did it.
Some point.
Oh, I bet it was Joanne. Think Joanne will let me help her with her sculpture when we get back?
Hell yeah. You're like the magic assistant.
It's nice to be able to use my power out here. Not hide it.
Yeah, Karen was right. They're all cool with it.
Joanne is spelled J-O-A-N-N-E.
Amazing that anything can grow out here.
Does it ever rain in the desert?
Well,
once in a while.
Good question.
Seldomly.
Anyway, what I was saying is, are these things poisonous or something?
It's a cactus, dude.
That's a prickly
pear. It stings. That's all.
Yeah.
Lame.
You can barely see the little needles going in you from those things. Can you get that, Daniel?
Now what the hell is that?
My legs are gonna be like yours after all this hiking now.
Huh. Oh wait.
Now what the hell is that? Daniel? I see something behind this rock.
That's pretty handy power.
Can you bring it over?
It's a gold doubloon.
Gotcha. I see. Here it comes. Ooh, look at that. So cool.
Yep. We're taking this treasure.
What is that? New souvenir. Okay. It was wrapped with this thing, or did we add that at some point? Flashlight. Pretty useless with the crazy moonlight we had, but it scares coyotes away. Now I'll be able to look at the stars in a new way. Thanks, Karen. This is the same stuff he said. Sorry, hippies. We still gotta have our candy. Joan makes the best curries ever. Karen hooked us up with some cool camping gear. We definitely have to get a telescope like this. Gotta give it back to Arthur when you get back. So I can still kind of smell Dad on this blanket. Still miss you, Pepito. You always will miss him. We can't hop down from there.
Damn.
What?
I've got the munchies. Hope Karen has some food.
Can he just levitate himself down?
You know, I could have done it by myself, right?
Yeah.
Hey, let me be the cool, helpful big brother once in a while.
Ooh, look!
That's one thing we've never seen him do, levitate himself. Just realize that.
Oh, man! I just saw a cool baby lizard!
Yeah.
Aw.
And you scared it.
I know.
Oh, shit.
What?
That wasn't here yet.
Whoa. How did that happen?
Rock slide, I guess. Looks like a job for our local super psychic boy.
Yeah. Yeah, that would be hard to climb over.
So, maybe you can help us get out of here?
I'll try. Step back.
Be super careful.
Whoa.
There you go. I hope it's okay.
Nice, man.
That's the place, huh? They call it a commune? It might be BLM land. Bureau of Land Management. I mean, the only thing with that is you can park there, you can't build structures on it, so I'm not sure. They said these two guys built a house there. It's not really allowed.
Hey, I'm gonna go see what Joanne is doing.
Go for it. I have to bring back the telescope to Stanley and Arthur.
So they got a deck here for the trailer.
Went to town for weekly supplies. Some pancakes left in the kitchen? Back soon.
We like a pancakes.
Daniel, you copy?
Yes, I read you. 10-4.
I have a pancake alert in the kitchen. Repeat. Pancake alert.
Oh, man. Sorry, I was gonna eat with Joanne. Over and out.
10-4. No flying pancakes today.
Okay. Now we look around, all around.
Karen has been camping in her own house since we arrived.
Doesn't look long enough for anyone to stretch out in.
Either Karen was desperate for a job, or she loved working with kids.
I don't think she likes kids that much. Happy World Resort, Florida. Karen, 40th anniversary summer. If she likes kids, she just doesn't have, like having kids.
Whoa.
Oh, wow.
I hope Karen sends this to Clarence Steven.
Gotta read this. Hi, Mom and Dad. I've been thinking about this letter for a while. I know it's been a long, long time coming. So I'm sitting here tonight thinking about the words I should have written 10 years ago. You always used to say everything happens for a reason. Some reason. We fought about it then. Why is that, like, a gray? Oh, it's struck out, but you can still read it. Right, so that's crossed out. We fought about it then. I understand why now. There's a reason I feel like I have to reach out to you both tonight from the desert. I guess this is a rough draft. I know you've only heard from me once by phone and 6 times by letter for almost a decade. I'm sorry, crossed out. I didn't mean to hurt you. I was certainly not trying to punish you, like you told me, it's crossed out. Don't laugh, but I just didn't know what to say or write. Poet's block. Just like you had to block me from your life after I left Esteban. I understand that was how you had to deal with, crossed out, a problem child, an only child who didn't live up to your expectations. There's no denying that I failed you, but the burden, crossed out, weight of your aspirations as parents failed me too. You had such a rigid opinion of what I was supposed to be that I just didn't have the chance, crossed out, opportunity to explore who I really actually was. You wanted a daughter to grow up happy, find a good job, and great husband, settle down to breed, is crossed out, have kids, and raise them in faith to continue the cycle of suburbia. This is crossed out. That daughter wasn't me. I know that you were raised in a different time and culture, so I didn't understand your point of view, like you didn't understand your wayward daughter. Maybe a bridge too far for us at the time. After Danny was born, you knew I wanted to take, cross out, a break, some time to figure things out in my head and heart. It didn't make sense to, cross out, you or Dad that I get that, but, crossed out, you didn't see how I was so desperate, and only Esteban was willing to give me that time because he saw how unhappy I was. I don't blame you for your decision to leave, and maybe a timeout would have led to the same outcome. We will never know, and I try not to live in regret. My life has been a roller coaster, and there have been times I long to hear your voices and thoughts. Even the negative ones have been crossed out. And I know when I last talked to you in New York to ask for help in paying back my debts, you wanted to help, but it was on your condition to return back, right back to where I couldn't return. I hate that was our last conversation. I am sorry I reached out to you this day. I am sorry I broke your hearts. I am sorry I let you broke mine for silencing me for so long. Yeah, cross that out and put break. I think we paid our dues, and now I sit under a blue field of crystal stars like the poet I hope I am, writing and waiting for a chance to rebuild an old bridge with my mother and father. I hope you can cross it one more time. Love, and she crossed out the word love, your daughter. Wow. Pretty hefty. He literally just looks at it and says nothing. Birthday candle?
Daniel's Big Ten late birthday party.
Oh, yeah.
Made him feel so happy.
A note.
Karen doesn't even like to leave this place just to go shopping.
God, there's sometimes.
Karen must have been so excited to finally hit New York.
Fly by night, not by fright, into the big city bright, stop. That cliché never dying in the steel of the buildings, the warp of the street, but no matter where, what or where I spin, the pull of a million dead poets takes me to dance once again. Go. But this time I get to lead until the next flight.
Karen looks so young and fragile on this picture. Hard times.
In this picture. Maggie and Karen, summer 11, Kissimmee, Florida. Objectives? Bring the telescope back to Arthur and check on Daniel. Oh, you have something to say about this? Relics from another life, his ID card. Oh, the keys? Same. Still haven't checked it. Maybe now is the right time? Yeah, I'm gonna grab that. I remember seeing those things there before. Is there a computer here to use? Group picture?
Looks like they all finally found their home.
Yeah. Ooh, pancakes. Hot sauce.
I do remember Karen would drown her pancakes in hot sauce.
Ugh.
Ugh. Gross.
I mean, don't get me wrong, I love me some hot sauce, but to drown it? Pancakes in it?
I'm so glad Jacob and his sister are doing okay. They deserve some peace.
May 29th. Hola, Sean. Sorry I did not write to you sooner, but this was the first time I've had a chance to relax after we got out of Haven Point, thanks to you and your brother. I still can't believe it really happened. So bizarre. Sarah Lee and I do miss our parents, but we're not ready to let them know where we are yet. We will figure it out later. Thanks to my old savings account, I finally got Sarah Lee antibiotics, so she's been feeling better pretty fast. Kids are like superhumans. Oh, where's our wallet? No money. Supposed to have that in our backpack, too. Sorry. The most important thing to me is my sister, just like your brother. You're lucky to have each other, and when you both came our way, we were blessed. I'm trying to track down our Humboldt crew, so I'll keep you posted. I hope everybody is okay after that night on the farm. We all deserve a break and a better future. Yeah, look up, what's his name? Finn in jail, probably, at this point. Pending trial, probably. Please let me know when you make it to the other side. You and Daniel got this. Give our little hero a big hug. Take care, Jake.
So cute. Looks like Lila has some competition now.
Huh. Hi, Daniel. Hope you're good and happy. I feel so much better now. It took forever before we found a place to live, but we finally did. I love this cold weather way more than the heat. Please come see us soon. Thanks for being one of my best friends, Sarah Lee. Lesson 3. Rhymes. Our bed. Big enough for both of you?
So good to have a home. Again.
Temporary.
And a real bed.
Okay, there's a laptop. Snake clamp. Oh, that thing.
Ugh. I wish Karen didn't tell me she got a rattlesnake out of the toilet last week.
Oh, never mind. I thought... You know what I thought that was at first? I thought it was the thing he broke off from the hospital.
Karen letting us invade her space.
But he didn't take that.
After all these years. That's something.
I mean, it wasn't showed, but I'm sure that he just dropped that thing. Once he got out of the hospital.
Gotta keep my eye lube handy. Glad I don't need it as much.
Eye lube.
She changed my diapers, but... It feels kind of awkward to be here.
Yeah. There's another life.